Happy Sunday morning to you. Good morning, good morning. Good morning, friends. I'm glad to see you this morning. Thank you for joining in this morning. This is just such a wonderful day. It's so beautiful, and we just praise God for He continues to show His goodness and share in His blessings in our life. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, I just want to thank you for joining on this morning. Can you believe it's only 13 days away from Christmas? I mean, oh my goodness, it has come really fast. Good morning, Miss Donna. Good to see you this morning. Praise God. It's a little chilly here in North Carolina. I know that in other parts of the United States, it's a little cool too. Amen. Watching from Arizona. Amen. Amen. How's Arizona doing? Amen. Glory to God. It's a good day. Praise the Lord. You know, I just want to take a second and encourage you this morning just to keep out of stress. It's easy. This is a time of the year that it's easy just to get in stress, just get stressed over things. So we just need to take our time. Trust the Lord, you know, everything's going to work out. It's going to come together. And, you know, we just got to remember that after all, that it's about the gift of Jesus this season. And it's what we're celebrating. And it's sharing His love with others. And so that's what we need to do. Amen. Praise the Lord. Well, amen. We just need to remember to release our faith. Release our faith for whatever you're believing for. If you're believing for something that you need spiritually, physically, financially, emotionally, release your faith for it. Let's believe God together. Amen. Good morning, Miss Kathy. Glad you're watching this morning. Thank you for tuning in. Praise the Lord. Amen. It's time to continue to stay in faith and stay faithful to the word. Amen. We all know this, but I'm just trying to give you a heads up, knowing that we're glad for the Lord. Amen. For His, and He gives us faith. You know, He gives us just a grain of a mustard seed is all it takes. Just that small of faith. So we can do it. We can stay in faith and believe God. Praise the Lord. Well, I'm going to go ahead and get started. I know there's only a few on this morning, but I'm going to get started this morning. And let's just pray together. Father, in the name of Jesus, I am so grateful. We are so grateful. We're grateful for Your goodness. We're grateful for the blessings that You give us every day. We're just grateful for another day to be a blessing to somebody, another day that we can speak Your word, another day that we can glorify You, that we can just give You the praise and the glory. Father, this is the day that You've made. And each day that You give to us, Lord, we take that opportunity to rejoice in You and thank You for it. Thank You for this day. Thank You for the opportunity to serve You. Thank You for an opportunity to speak Your word and to press on towards the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Father, I thank You for for my brothers and sisters in the Lord, and I ask You to bless them this morning. Open the eyes of their understanding. Reveal to them the secrets of Your word through the preaching of Your word through this day, Father, in the name of Jesus. We'll give You the glory. We give You the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. You know, I know this month has been a little stressful, and probably for some people, maybe more than for others. And I think the main thing is to remember that we need to stay in peace. We need to, even in the midst of all of the hustle and the bustle of the Christmas preparations, or just the, you know, getting ready for Christmas in itself, that we just need to stay in peace. We just need to find that peace. You know, if we're not really watchful, the stress or the concern of things can turn into, you know, worry, which then goes directly into fear, and then that just turns into tormenting us, and we don't need that. We don't need to be tormented. I'm reminded of Philippians 4:7. It says, God's peace, which goes beyond anything we can imagine, will guard our thoughts and our emotions through Christ Jesus. It's his peace. But the key is that we have to invite his peace into our life and into the circumstances that we're facing every day. You've got to invite it. You can't just expect it to show up. You've got to make way for it. You've got to prepare for it. Amen? Amen. You got to allow it to minister to you. Amen. Receive it. Amen. Just receive it. And what that really means is when we have these cares and we have these situations or concerns, and we just need to cast that over on the Lord. It says, cast your cares on the Lord. He will sustain you. He will never let the righteous be shaken. That is in Psalms 55 and verse 22. You know, you might ask, or somebody might even ask one day, well, how do you cast your cares over on the Lord? You kind of have to do that one thought at a time. You have to take that thought and you have to tell it, nope, I'm not going to give you place. You have no place in my mind. You have no place here. I refuse to allow you to operate and to continue, and I cast it down in the name of Jesus. Amen. And then you just say, Lord, I give this care over to you. I just trust you in this situation. Amen. This is over in your hands. Amen. Because you are well able to resolve it. He is. He is well able to resolve it. And you know, it's just taking captive every thought. It's like capturing the thought, bringing it into subjection to the Word of God, making the Word over it instead of it over the Word. Amen. And then, you know, that I know that doesn't just stop the thoughts. What happens is thoughts will continue to come, but it's the resisting. It's continually resisting it, continually verbally speaking out. I have to speak out. Speak out for it. Tell it, I'm not going to have you operate in my life. I'm not going to have you there. Amen. You have to keep telling it no. And then you thank God for resolving it. That's how you capture the thought. And we do have to do that many times a day. And that's just training ourselves how to resist and how to cast down. Amen. Praying in the Spirit, we know, is a great help. And it always helps to pray in the Spirit to get victory over those situations. And, you know, because the Spirit of God knows what to pray for. He knows how to take care of those things. And then if you replace those thoughts with the Word of God, if you'll take that Word, that find a scripture on it, take that Word of God, start beginning to think about that scripture, begin to murmur it to yourself, speak it out loud, tell yourself that scripture, then that'll take a place of those thoughts. That's casting the cares over on the Lord. And you know, that's humility. That is humility, because worrying and taking on that anxiety is prideful. It's very, very prideful. Because what happens is when it's prideful, is we begin to believe that what happens is ultimately our control. We're saying, well, it's up to me to take care of this. We're not casting it over on the Lord. We're not trusting him to take care of this situation. And we cannot stay in pride, because pride, God opposes pride. Amen? He opposes pride. It says in 1 Peter 5 and verse 6, it says, therefore, humble yourselves under the mighty hand of God, that he may exalt you in due time, casting your care upon him, for he cares for you. Praise God. We got to recognize that God has grace, and he's giving us that grace. He wants you to operate in his grace. You have a need for his grace. I have a need for his grace. We need that grace. Amen. And God, it says, like I said a minute ago, God resists the proud, but it says he multiplies grace and favor when we're humble. So we need to continue to stay humble before the Lord, realizing we can't solve this problem. We can't solve the situation. Whatever we're stressing over, take it, cast it over on the Lord. Let him take care of it. Amen. Now, some of us have financial situations and financial pressures that come, especially this time of the year, because we're trying to do it all. We're trying to buy all of the presents, and we want to go over and beyond because we have such a heart for giving that we want to go over and beyond all of that. And sometimes people get themselves in financial situations where it's difficult to take care of things at the same time that you're buying all the presents, and then there's a struggle. Amen. Amen. So we don't want to do that. Christmas is giving. Amen. And it is great to give. Everybody loves to be able to give. Amen. But it's not to the place where we stress out over it. Don't stress out over it. Amen. There's no stress or pressure in giving. You know, there's more than one way to give. And you can give besides monetary ways or physical ways. You can give in, let's say, acts of service. That is a great way to give, whether it's making a special dessert that you can share with someone, or maybe it's babysitting those kiddos for someone that they can go out and have a moment, free moment, or maybe it's just sending cards of encouragement. Those are ways of what we call acts of service that will keep the stress level down and help you be a giver in the same way. Don't always have to give monetarily. Amen. You just find that need and meet that need according to the ability that God has placed on you and in you. You have an ability, you have a gift, and so let God use that gift through you. Amen. Proverbs 3:27 says, "Do not withhold good from the deserving when it is within your power to act." So there is something we can do in giving rather than just giving a monetarily a gift or financially or whatever. We can do something for somebody. Amen. Amen. Praise the Lord. You know, another thing that happens in this season is we have a lot of people that are alone in this season, and they're very lonely. It happens, loneliness comes, and people struggle with that. Amen. And I know that in recent years, there have been a lot of family members or relatives that have passed away and gone on to glory, and these people are left alone, or maybe they are going through an emotional time, and it's very difficult and emotional. Sometimes we don't recognize that. But that's when we have to draw on the Lord's strength. We have to really draw on the Lord's strength. And we, as people who are alone, welcome those encouraging thoughts. So welcome those encouraging texts and emails and cards and letters, those Christmas cards that come in the mail. People welcome that when they're alone. They look forward to that. And we have such wonderful technology today, like the internet, where we can get on and we can see one another. I have this app on my phone that's called Duo, and I use that a lot to talk with my family members that are in other parts of the country. And it's absolutely wonderful. I'm so thankful that we have this technology. We're not completely isolated. Amen. Psalms 25 and verse 16 in the Passion Translation says, "Sorrows fill my heart as I feel helpless. I'm all alone and in misery. Come closer to me now." He's crying out to the Lord. "Come closer to me now because I need your mercy. Turn to me, for my problems seem to be going from bad to worse. Only you can free me from all of these troubles." And that's true. It's only the Lord that we reach out to. We grab onto him, that we lean into him and trust him to help us through all of those times that we're feeling alone. You know, I remember a long time ago, we did a study, Pastor and I did a study on the eye. And he says the eye is a funny thing. When we look at an object, when we're looking at it on the inside of our eye, we see that object upside down and reversed. But when we look outward, it's right side up, and it looks great. We can see naturally great. And I think if you look at it in another way, the lesson we can learn here today is when we stop looking inward and thinking about what about me, what about my needs, what about what I'm going through, And we begin to reverse that and turn it around and look outwardly and see that there are many other people that are going through things, many other people that are struggling in areas of their life, that if we'll begin to pray or minister to them and listen to the Holy Spirit, do what He says to minister to them, to bring life to them, and to bring them to a place that they can hear God and get victory over these areas in their life, that it will be taking our thoughts off of ourselves and being that minister that we are called to be. Amen. So when you're feeling lonely, in any case, and you know, you can be with people and still feel lonely, but when you're feeling that way, begin to minister to others. Begin to listen to others' conversations. You have friends that you call or people that you talk with. Listen to their conversations. Find out what's really happening in their life, how you can minister to them in a way that you can share love and giving into their life. Then we won't be single visioned. We won't just see ourselves. Amen. But we're going to be seeing what God sees, and we're able to share His grace and His love. Amen. Now, there's not only people that have lost loved ones this season, but there's also a lot of military spouses that are alone, that their spouses are in the military and they're overseas or stationed somewhere. Or perhaps there's divorced people, those that have gone through a really tough time. And then there's orphaned children or people who are alone in a nursing facility. There are people all over that are going through situations that need help. And we need to be spiritually sensitive so that we can minister God's love and grace to them. Amen. Because not everybody that we talk with is going to share their pain. They're just not. Amen. Luke 19:13 says, "And he called his 10 servants and delivered them 10 pounds. And he said unto them, occupy till I come." We're supposed to be doing something while Jesus is, before he returns. We're supposed to be doing something right here. Jesus left us his Holy Spirit. He left us his word, and he left us everything that pertains to life and godliness. And he wants us, let's think about that like the 10 pounds. He leaves us something to do, and he says, occupy till I come. Now, I looked that up because I wanted to see what some of the commentary said about that. And I like this particular commentary, who is Benson, is who it is. And this is what he said about occupy till I come. He says, "Till I return, make an account of the use you have made of what has been entrusted to your management." The spiritual sense of this is, use your endowments, your gifts, and graces with all of your privileges and advantages for the good of your fellow creatures and the glory of God. See, that's right there telling us, occupy till we come. Take what I've given you, the gifts, the talents, the things that I've given you, the abilities, share it and do my work. Share my love. Do what I've called you to do. We've all been called to something, and all of us have been called to the ministry of reconciliation, getting people born again, introducing them to Jesus. You can do that by sharing the love of Jesus. Amen. It's the love of God that brings people to repent. Amen. Now, Matthew Henry also had a commentary, and it says, he said that verse means those that are called to Christ, he furnishes with gifts needful for their businesses. And from those to whom he gives power, he expects service. In other words, he gives these scriptures. The manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to profit withal. That's in 1 Corinthians 12 and verse 7. And then he says, and as everyone who has received the gift, so let him minister the same. Amen. 1 Peter 4:10. You see, there is something we need to do. We need to share the love of Christ. We need to share the word of God. We need to share his grace. Amen. Amen. We need to do those things. Praise God. Praise God. Now, What I mentioned this morning are only just a few things that we face during this holiday season. I can realize that there are more difficult times for some than there are for others, but I think we just need to remember that we don't always know the extent of someone's circumstances, that we need to be sensitive to the Spirit of God and listen to what the Spirit of God is saying, because they might be experiencing something we don't know anything about. And if we get cranky or snippy or sassy, I like to say, then what happens is then we aren't that minister and we aren't being very compassionate. Now, you can act compassionate to people you don't know and not to your family. Or you can act compassionate to those that you know because you know them, and not to strangers, to people that you meet in the store or whenever you go somewhere. That's really, if you don't act compassionate and show the love of God and the grace of God to everyone, what happens is we become hypocritical in our faith and our witness of Jesus's love. So if you're going to be nice to everybody. Share the love of God. Don't just do it to your family and not to somebody else. Or don't just do it to others and not your family, thinking, well, they know who I am. They just need to get over it. No, be nice. I know Pastor Michael used to always say this. He used to always say, treat that family member like they were somebody else's family member, like somebody else's mother, somebody else's brother, somebody else's sister or child. Treat them like they were somebody else's relative. Amen. Honor and respect are planting seeds when you do that to somebody else, and you're going to reap that in yours. Amen. I'm going to end with a few scriptures, and then I'm going to pray for you. Amen. Ephesians 4:32 says, be kind and compassionate to one another, forgiving each other, God forgave you. Amen. Luke 6:35, but love your enemies and do good and lend, expecting nothing in return. See, when you give and when you show that love, don't expect it back. You might not get it back because they're going through something. Amen. It says, and your reward will be great, and you will be the sons of the Most High, for he is kind to the ungrateful and the evil. Colossians 3:12 says, put on then, as God's chosen ones, holy and beloved, compassionate hearts, kindness, humility, meekness, and if one has a complaint against another, forgiving each other, as the Lord has forgiven you, so you also must forgive. Amen. Galatians 6:10. So then, as we have the opportunity, let us do good to everyone, and especially those are of the household of faith, especially our brothers and sisters in the Lord. And then the last scripture is 1 Peter 3 and verse 8 says, finally, all of you have unity of mind, sympathy, brotherly love, and tender heart and a humble mind. Do not repay evil for evil or reveling for reveling, but on the contrary, bless, for to this you were called, that you may obtain a blessing. Amen. Obtain a blessing. So we just need to remember, stay out of stress this year. Stay out of stress. Don't let the stress of the world come upon you. Don't let the stress of the season come upon you. Give your cares over to the Lord. Trust the Lord. Be kind. Amen. And then you will be a blessing to those that you come in contact with. Thank you all for joining me. I just wanted to take a few minutes this morning to encourage you in the Lord, to encourage you to think and about the Lord in all that you do. Be sensitive to Him. Now, I know God is working in your behalf and preparing you for 2022. I was reminded this week by a friend who sent me this prophetic word from Dr. Jerry Seville, And he said, and this is an encouraging word, I have to share it. He said that this is the year of the open hand of God, the year of unusual, extraordinary, supernatural provision. Listen, church, receive that from the Lord today. Receive that as a personal revelation to you that God is going to do something supernatural, unusual, and extraordinary by his hand this coming year. Amen. Amen. Stay faithful. Stay in faith. Stay strong in the Lord. And let me pray for you. Father God, I thank you for all those that have listened today, that have listened to this message. Father, I just pray that your Spirit would empower them to stay strong in you, would empower them and enable them to be strong in the Spirit of God, that you would come deep within their hearts, and Father, that you would give them the strength to carry on each day, that you would help them find the good in every situation, that you would help them, Father, be a minister of love and of grace to others. Father, I pray that you would bless them in abundance, heal their bodies, give them the peace that they need that passes all understanding. I thank you, Father, for your grace and your mercy, and I thank you for your goodness in Jesus' name. Amen. Love you all so much. I love you, love you, love you. Keep in touch. Amen. God bless.